Gasification?
Gasification! Gasification! Yep, we're going to make some wood gas. Now, this is an old technology, and basically, if you burn wood in a high temperature, low oxygen environment, it will give off a gas. Now, it's kind of a little bit like charcoaling. So, I kind of done this as like a little brief experiment, just to see if it does work. If you fill this pot up in here with wood, cap it off, have a little pipe come off, you know, fill the outside of this with fire, then you will get a smoke come off it, but within that smoke is gas, and if you light it with a blowtorch, you can kind of see a bit of a glimmer of a flame. We're going to make a better one because I want to run an engine on this, so we need to clean that smoke up because it's full of all sorts of impurities. So we get rid of them, you can run engines off it. I've got this old lawnmower. We're basically going to make a gasifier, set it on the top, so we can have wood burning, the gas can go in, and we can be mowing our lawn. And we don't need any fuel station or electricity. No, we've got me wood gasifier mower. Whoa, new first merch. More about that at the end of the video. Right, let's get on with it. Time for one of those colinfurze build montages. But what is it, Colin, and how does it work? Well, the first version that we did that we showed you outside, you basically built a fire around the pot, you filled it full of wood, it gave off the gas, you siphoned it off, bosh. This one's not quite like that. No, you do still fill this little chamber of wood, nice little lid there, I like it. So, all the wood sits at the bottom on our little grate thing, that little plate with all the holes in, and this little handle thing is a shaker, because as it burns, it will kind of like, you know, disintegrate, and then it will all want to drop out the bottom as like slag or whatever, and that's what that does. You can kind of agitate it, flick it around. So then, you've got a fire at the bottom of a massive great pile of wood, but it doesn't burn up, it burns down, and it does that because on the outlet here, there is going to be fan attachment. This is a bit crude at the moment, but it's just for the test. We'll shove that on there, and then basically that's going to suck air down here and also down here, get onto that in a minute, through the wood into the bit where it's burning, and then it will pull all the smoke out underneath into the outside bit of this chamber and then out there and then off to an engine where we can burn it. Now then, this little bit at the bottom here, this is like my slag catchment area. So with this look, we can just pull this out, and then this little spay thing will just drag it out into a bucket and then we drop it back in again. Woo! Now, this pipe here, this is the air in, so we can kind of regulate how much air we send just to the bottom, because once it starts burning, you'll close the top and it'll only suck through there. Now then, where's the gas come from? Well, essentially, that fire at the bottom of this inner pot is going to create heat, which will then charcoal the wood above the fire, give off the gas, and then this is the weird bit. It's going to pull the gas through the fire and then out. Now I'm like thinking, well, why doesn't it all just burn up? But it probably hasn't got enough oxygen to burn that and the wood, which is why we need to keep the oxygen down to a minimum. So then, is it going to work? Right, let's go and give it a test. It's sort of getting there. Proof of concept, it's kind of working, I think. I think I'm gonna have to buy another fan. And that's why the fan's not working. Yeah, that's gotta be too hot. Okay, that was actually a successful experiment. You could see flammable gas within the smoke, but of course, a plastic fan that close to it, it's just not coped and it was never gonna work anyway. But I did say it was temporary. Now, what we need to do now, as well as cooling the gases down, we need to get rid of all the muck, because you can see on the lid here, all this black tar which comes out of the smoke. It's horrible, it's sticky, it stinks. We need to get rid of that. We don't want that in our engine. It's just gonna wreck it. So, I think we need to make some filters. Okay, we're getting there. Wood gas comes out the top, round the cyclone, up the tube, got a little jar to see if we've got any of that mucky stuff, and the pipe, down the pipe, then up into this little filter unit, which is basically a pipe up the middle with steel wool in it, and then it goes down the outside of that, and that's got like wood chippings and stuff in there to filter it even more, and then out to the engine. I've got this little clear thing on the top here so we can see if anything's happening and see if it's like any smoky stuff in there. Very nice. Right. Messing around with a lawnmower, managed to get it running. It is a runner. Let's get this mounted on the top and see if it works. Yes. Okay, she's mounted on the mower. Now, we've got a little valve set up here. I've put it into the carb with a little 3D printed adapter. I've taken the fuel tank off, so it is definitely only running on wood gas. I've taken it off completely, so you can't look at me and go, Colin, you're cheating, there's fuel in there. There's not. Right, we've got a valve here, which is gonna regulate the air going into the carburetor. We've got this valve, which is gonna regulate the wood gas going into the carburetor. And then we've got this one, which we can turn off the fan. The fan still might not be any good, it might melt again, but hopefully after it's been through all this malarkey, it would have cooled down enough and it will be fine. We've got the speed controller for the van, it's all mounted, the battery's on there, we've got some wood in, you know. Yes! Jar's gone a bit murky, getting warm. I don't think we're quite there yet.
Yeah, it's working. Working, look.
There you go. Might be a bit better now.
It's got a lot of water in it, look.
Well, it's not working, but I think the wood might be too wet. I've got a lot of drips and stuff around here, and that's not going to be helping nobody. So I think I'll take all the wood out and get some drier wood. Okay, still loads of tar, so I've had a little bit of a look online and I don't think it's running hot enough, so I think I'm going to have a little look at the burner. This is the old one, doesn't taper down that much, and this is the new one, does taper down. So, got a thinner end, got a little bit of a catchment area here, slightly different shaker grate, and then we've got four air inlets rather than one big one. All adjustable, I'd say let's whack it in. I think we're getting there. Come on! Come on! Fresh air required! Why am I doing this inside? It's the shed, everything happens in the shed, doesn't it?
We've got a bit of a glow down there, look, as you can see.
Okay, version 750. I've changed the grate at the bottom to a cup because I think the fire we're producing is dropping too easily through that, so that's going to hold it a little bit more. Also, I'm going to light it from the top with sparklers because I think lighting it from the bottom, we're not getting a deep enough fire and therefore it's not producing as much heat as I want it to produce. Then, to get rid of the moisture, oh, we've had another load of pipes, it's like a radiator, and some more jars down the bottom there to hopefully collect the moisture. Come on, let this be the one. Just want to mow my lawn. This is more like it. Nearly stays lit. I finally cut my lawn on the power of wood! The lawnmower is set way too high, it's literally not cutting it. Now, once it's running, it doesn't sound any different and it doesn't smell any different to a normal lawnmower. And it's at this point I was going to go out and film me mowing the lawn using the power of wood gas. But after I switched it off and let it cool down, it won't start. So it's completely seized the inlet valves off. Because basically, Colin, my filter system is not big enough. I've tried to make it compact to fit it on the lawnmower, but all this side of things needs to be a lot bigger because the amount of tar and goo I've got going into the engine is still far too much. But it is a learning curve. This is the first one I've ever made. I'm going to make a better one in the future because I want to power the bunker using wood gas. Now, I did mention at the beginning of the video, we've got some new colinfurze merchandise. Yes. We've got the Hovercops hooded top. These are available in youth sizes as well. We've got this wonderful one. And then, oh, look at that. There's a nice little t-shirt. And there's also a darker one. Oh, look at that. Grey and black. They're nice. Now, there is a link in the description in the colinfurze shop. There, of course, all the other merchandise, which I do. I try and make it the best quality as possible and try and make it a little different to other people's merchandise. So get involved, support the channel. And then the next video is kind of related to this because when I'm mowing the lawn, I'm fed up with moving the swing around. So I've got history with swings. I made a massive 360 swing. It's kind of going to be a little bit like that. There we are. Subscribe. Wait for the next video because it's going to be about swinging. See.